Hello students, last day we have learned about the exponents, laws and exercise 2a. So today we will learn about the standard form and usual form to write exponents. So at first, I would like to say what is a standard form. Standard form means, suppose there is a number 4, 5, 6, 7, 0, 0, 0. So as we can see that this number is not written in an exponential form. So we will convert this into exponential form. So there we have three zeros. So we can straight away write it as 4, 5, 6, 7 into 10 to the power 3 because there are three zeros. So here now we have 4, 5, 6, 7. So that means if I write this number in decimal, this will become 4567.0. And suppose I want to convert this decimal into this part. So standard form means we have to put the decimal point after one digit. So that means here after 4 we will have a decimal point 5, 6, 7. And this 10 to the power 3 will remain same. Now for shifting this decimal to this side, we have to look that how many digits we are shifting. So here we are shifting 1, 2, 3 digits. So that is why another 10 to the power 3 will come. So this is the standard form. Now in standard form, these two are the same bases. So we have to add up the exponents here. So this will give us 4.567 multiplied with 10 to the power 3 plus 3. So that means 4.567 into 10 to the power 6. So this is the standard form for writing an exponent. Now the next one will be our usual form. Usual form is just the opposite of standard form. That means suppose we were having this number 4.567 into 10 to the power 6. So this was the last number we got in standard form. So this is basically the standard form. But converting this into the usual form means making it just like before. So that means here if I remove the point, for removing the point we have to divide this with how many digits we are removing? 1, 2, 3 digits. So that is why here we will have 1000. And here we are having 10 to the power 6. So that means we can write 6 zeros, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 zeros. So if I cancel these two, only 3 zeros are remaining and here no decimal point is there. So that means this number will become 4, 5, 6, 7, then 000, 1, 2, 3. So this is the usual form of writing an exponent. Now the question is, why we use this standard form and usual form? So suppose the distance between Earth and Sun. So the distance between Earth and Sun is very huge, so we cannot calculate it. So for that purpose, what we write is, we can write something like 5.4 into 10 to the power, suppose 13. So that means 13 zeros. So this we can write in kilometer, distance can be measured in kilometer. So this is a very big number, which while writing in the copy will give us some trouble. So that is why we use this exponential and standard. So now the next one is express the following in standard form. So there are two different type of sums. So this one we have many zeros and this one we have decimal point. So both are in a different way. So this one, first one, we have 1354 and there are 4 zeros. So for solving this, for 4 zeros we can take it as 10 to the power 4. Then 1354, we can assume that there is a decimal point here. So this decimal point will come here because in standard form after one digit we get decimal point. So how many digits it will shift? 1, 2, 3 digits. So that means 1.354 into 10 to the power 4. With this we will multiply 10 to the power 3 because it is shifting 3 digits. So here we have to next apply laws of exponents here. The 10 have same base, so the exponents will get added up. one we have to convert into standard form. So for standard form, we know that there should be some 10 to the power, something will be there, but here it is not present, right? So for converting to standard form, here we will do just the opposite. For this sum, we had taken the decimal to this side, but here we will take the decimal to this side. So how many digits are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. So after point, we have 4 digits. So that's why we will have 1, 2, 3, 4 zeros, and this decimal point will remove. So after that, we will have only 3, because before 3, these have no values. So 3 into 3 divided by 4 zeros. So for ideally standard form, we can write it as 3 into 10 to the power. This becomes 10 to the power 4. So 10 to the power 4, when goes to the numerator, that becomes 10 to the power minus 4. So for writing in standard form, we can write this 3 as 3.0 into 10 to the power minus 4. Because for standard form, after one digit, you always take a decimal. So for decimal, you can write 3 as 3.0. Now next, we have usual form. We have to convert, and we have standard form here. So it says that express the following usual form. The first one is this. So for usual form, we know that 10 to the power, this thing will not be there. So no exponent will be there. So number one, 4.61 into 10 to the power 5, we can write it as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 zeros. For removing this decimal, we have to shift it 2 digits. So that means here we will get 100, and this decimal will be removed. Now these 2 zeros and these 2 zeros will cancel. So here we are getting 4.61 and then 1, 2, 3 zeros. So this is our usual form. Now next one is 7.62 into 10 to the power 4. Same we will do here. We will first write this 10 to the power 4 as 1, 2, 3, 4 zeros. And for shifting this decimal 2 digits, we will write 100 here. And this decimal will be removed. Now cancelling them, we will be getting 762, then 2 zeros. So these two are in usual form. Now let us solve exercise 2b. So exercise 2b, first one says write each of the following in standard form. So at first we are having this 57.36. So that means for writing in standard form, we have to get this decimal point here. So suppose I am taking 5.736. So for getting this decimal point here, we can have another 10 here, so that means 10 to the power 1. So this is our standard form. Now the second one, number 5, it has 4, 6, 3 and then 10 zeros. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 zeros. So for this, we can first take 463 into 10 to the power 10, instead of 10 zeros I am writing. So now here we will put the decimal point after 4. So after one digit, that is after 4, we are having the decimal point. And this will become 10 to the power 10. Then for 2 digits shifting, this will be 10 to the power 2. So that means these two will get added up. So it will become 4.63 into 10 to the power 10 plus 2, 12. So this is the number 5. Now number 6. Number 6 we have 345 into 10 to the power 5. So already it has exponential form here. So only what we need to do is we need to put a decimal point here. So for putting the decimal point after 3, we will have to shift this 2 digits. So for 2 digits, this will be 10 to the power 2. So that means the answer will be 3.45 into 10 to the power 5 plus 2 is 7. So this is our standard form. Now next, we have number 2, which says write each of the following numbers in usual form. So we have this in exponential form, that is in standard form, 6.912 into 10 to the power 8. So instead of 10 to the power 8, I can write 8 zeros. three zeros and the decimal point gets removed. So three zeros and three zeros will cancel. So this will become 6912, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 zeros. So this is the first one. Now number 6. Number 6 we have 1.679 into 10 to the power 9. So instead of 10 to the power 9, I am writing 9 zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And for this, we have to shift this decimal to 3 digits. So that means 1000. So this 1000 and this gets cancelled. The answer will be 1679, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now these two have been converted into usual form. So that's all for today, students. Next day we will solve the rest of the sums from exercise 2B. And please solve the rest of the sums from 1, number 1 and number 2 from the book.